In this video, we're gonna extend our power monitoring options by using this, and hopefully we're not gonna catch fire by doing it. For this project, we'll be using this rail switch. It is a Zigbee device, up to 63 amps selectable, and it has, of course, power meter function. If we open it up, inside we will find a pretty big manual and the rail switch itself. Except this power button, there is not too much that we can look at this device. So let's mount it up and see how it works. This is the panel with the mounted fuse. This is the fuse that it was just installed. Since I'm not sure about the quality of this unit, I basically left the original fuse in place, and from the output I fed this one through the top, and on the bottom part I connected the consumer. That way, if the quality for this one is sketchy, I will still have some level of protection left and hopefully nothing will burn. Now let's have a look at how the automation part for this will work. In Home Assistant, if we go to Zigbee2MQTT, we have the device already added. It sees it automatically, so you don't need to do anything specific. I called it Balcony Power Monitor. It is a router device. If we go to Exposes, the most interesting part are these settings. Of course, we see the current voltage. For now, there is zero current and power since I don't have anything connected on the output of the breaker. Temperature, overcurrent threshold. I have adjusted the limit to 16 amps. Overcurrent cutoff at 265 volts, under voltage at 75. Also, you have the option to adjust the power threshold, which is right now set at 3 kilowatts for the 16 amp rating that I have set. You can put anything here, 32 or whatever. I'm gonna leave it at 16 for now, since I don't have such a big power consumption over there and I don't want to have any unnecessary spillage. Now for the energy monitoring, we go to the dashboard, energy configuration, add consumption, and here we should find balcony power monitor energy. Use a static price, in my case it's 0.8, and done. We now have a better overview of our power consumption within the house. That's it for this short video. We did not catch fire, so if you enjoyed it, please don't forget to like and subscribe.